Plastic instruction video. Alright, so today we're gonna build a plastic shredder. And basically, this machine will chop your plastic waste into small plastic flakes. And these flakes will be used in the machines to make plastic bottles. The size of this machine is based on a plastic bottle. So we want you to make sure you can shred a plastic bottle. Everything smaller than a plastic bottle you can throw it in. If it's bigger, you need to keep on it. Or you need to build a bigger shredder. In this video, we will guide you step by step how to make a shredder. You can download all the technical information in the blueprint. And if you have a question or something is unclear, please post a comment in our forums. Alright, let's get started. This is the machine we have built. And basically, it consists out of four different parts. We have the shredding part, the power supply, the framework, and the hopper. And we're going to start off making the shredder. By far the most complex part of this machine. So if you follow our blueprints and this machine, we have a nice cutting flow for the shredder, but it's still good to play around and use different configurations. Shredder part, and now we're gonna focus on the power supply. And it's pretty straightforward, but there are some key things to watch out for. So here we have our beautiful engine. It doesn't really matter how it looks, or how big it is, or the size, we only need to make sure it's slow and powerful. The exact specifications you can download.
now we need to attach the motor to the shredder, so it will turn around. Then maybe we'll get a paint job.
And this is a great place to find cables to connect all the electronics. We have plenty of them. And usually we're gonna connect all the electronics in a metal box. If you wanna know how we do this, go watch our other videos. However, today we found this little guy. And inspired by the guys I met in Africa, we wanna connect all the electronics inside this one. All the electronics are inside this jerry can. We installed a switch here so we can make the motor go in both directions. Now we're going to hook it up to the framework and press the plastic. We finished up the shredder and the power supply, and now we're going to focus on the framework. And since there's a lot of force and strength going on in here, we need to make sure the framework is rock solid. So since our motor is slightly bigger than our cutting, we had to fill this gap. So use our blueprints as a reference, since you probably have a different engine. Just make sure that it's perfectly aligned from the power to the cutting. We're almost ready, and we finished up the shredder, the power supply, and the framework. But last but not least, we need to make the hopper. This is where the plastic weight goes through.
The hopper is made from sheet metal, and the different ways how to get sheet metal. Today we're going to use this one from a full truck. We're going to cut it out, weld it together, and then you can turn it on by using this little switch. And you can make it turn both ways. So if plastic gets stuck or something like that, you can turn it the other way around. And the plastic weight goes into the hopper, and then it will be shredded. So let's shred some plastic. gouge mesh, wind mesh. Do note that smaller watch plastic needs more energy and longer days. You can play around with this, like sorting out different colors or going really small or get bigger flakes. You can adapt it to whatever you need to make with it.
Thank you for watching the video. I